think it's extremely important for companies to be public. So we haven't really sort of delayed it actually, but the goal is still 2021, I think, as a target line. But for us, it's all about having the optionality, really, right? So we want to have the option to do it when we want. In our terms, and I think this last round of funding essentially it takes us all the way from here and to the other side of profitability, which has been the goal.
Was part of your hesitation the fact that you've looked at the landscape of tech IPOs this year in 2019, and it was a tricky ride? You know, there were many spectacular falls from the first day of trading for many of these tech IPOs. Did that scare you off a little bit?
I think it's absolutely clear if you look at last year, you'd probably rather be Zoom than WeWork, meaning you want to be profitable. For us, that's been a strong drive actually already starting in 2019. We're now well in line to achieve that here this year. So I think, you know, our goal for 2020 is to become profitable. Then we have the optionality in the market. And it's also very clear, I think, as a unicorn, there's a very, very strong push from the market to look at profitability. So I think it's very natural, and I think it's sort of a slight market adjustment, but a good one.
Do you detect a sea change then? Because, you know, the prevailing view is that 2019, we're seeing another tech bubble similar to what happened in early 2000, but it feels as though investors now are getting a lot more particular about which stocks they want to own and are really focusing on that profitability point.
Yeah, I think actually, I mean, from our side, what we think is sort of the boring is now sexy, right? So if you look at last year and the year before, it was all about consumer, it was all about sort of very flashy things, right? What we do is B2B. It's supply chains, it's heavy lifting for a lot of companies, but it's extremely integrated to the economy, it's extremely strategic to these companies. It's a lot more complex, and I think you see a lot of companies now that's been on the more boring side of the economy. I mean, Zoom is video conferencing, it's not super exciting either, but they're profitable and they've done well. So I think for us, that I think, you know, boring is essentially become the new sexy, right?
And just to bring it back to the profitability point, how are you planning on doing that? Is it by raising your revenues or by reducing your costs?
I mean, we've done both, right? And I think you see the number of unicorns. We restructured here in the beginning of the year. We took out a little cost, moved some more to some of our shared services. But on the other hand, we're also sort of growing our revenue very fast, right? So once you do that at a certain point and you just stall a little bit on cost, you're actually in a very good position.
So I've got to ask you, we're here in Davos, and I'm sure you've had many, many meetings, have been very busy. What are some of the top topics that have come up in your space?
So I think obviously, I mean, climate change is being taken seriously now. Mm. I think that's amazing. I think that's a big call. I mean,
by tech companies.
Yes, by everyone, right? I mean, Larry Fink came out and said, look, at BlackRock, we're now going to take it extremely seriously. We want to measure the companies on their performance. Mm-hmm. I think the second half of that sentence is extremely important, exactly how we're going to measure those companies. Yep. And then actually come back to the supply chain and how we're going to monitor everything that goes on. That's going to be a huge challenge for tech, for supply chain, for companies to manage. I think that's a really big thing. The other thing which is surprising is there's very little talk of either trade war or Brexit.
Yeah.
It seems to almost be resolved in people's mind. And I think that's actually also really, really good for the beginning of 2020. We can sort of focus on some bigger topics that are probably more relevant for all of us.
Is sustainability a topic that you think about?
Yes, a lot, right? So we're working with a lot of our customers to manage stuff like energy use, water footprint, sustainability, even child labor in their supply chains. And, you know, sort of our view is you've got to measure it before you can even manage it, right? So we work with all of the suppliers that large companies they work with on a daily basis, like Unilever, and make sure that they can sort of live up to their sustainability goals.